Hello, hello, welcome back to my channel. I am going to go through the new makeup releases and the announced new makeup releases of the last 2 weeks, I believe. I have been a little bit AWOL lately from my channel. I'm sorry for that. My personal life is a little bit hectic at the moment. I'm not going to tell, you know, why. It's a personal thing, and so that's why my uploads have been a little bit irregular lately. I'm sorry for that. I hope it will improve shortly, but for now I just want to talk new makeup. I have been collecting all the new makeup releases I saw on Beauty News and on the Trendmood page, and I just collected them over the last 2 weeks, put them in a little, you know, compilation, whatevs. I always do that, and then I thought it would be time to jump on here and just talk about some new makeup. And it's mainly palettes this time. It's really a lot of palettes. It's like we've had the foundation weeks and now we're going into the palette weeks, and then I think holiday. Yeah, it's trickling down. I've got I think a few of the releases are holiday related. So yeah, you know, let's just jump into the new makeup, guys. Let's jump in. Okay, I've scooched over a little bit. I have been trying out some new purple eyeshadow, as you can see. It's a bit more cooler toned. I like this a little bit more than the last look I had, but I'm not still not really convinced purple is for me, but you knows. All right, I am going to start off with Natasha Denona. Natasha Denona is going to release a limited palette. I think it's her holiday release. It's called the Metropolis, and it's a limited edition holiday palette. It's going to be $129 US dollars. I think that's usual for her. It's going to be 28 new shades and 2 new formulas of Natasha Denona's iconic professional quality pressed pigment eyeshadows in a never before seen midi size. So I think it's going to be the same size as the gold palette, the safari palette, and her usual bigger palette. But the main difference is that the pens are going to be smaller, and I believe it's going to be the same size as the Sunrise palette, one that just released. Very beautiful palette with the, I think, the purple packaging. The package is not going to be bigger, but the pens are going to be smaller, so you have more eyeshadows in the palette. And I must say, it looks stunning as usual. Very beautiful, really. And I don't own anything by Natasha Denona. It's just that I think I'm going to start with the gold palette. I'm going to London on Monday, guys. It's coming. It's getting so close. I'm going to put up a video, I think, about the stuff I want to buy. I hope I will be able to get that up on the weekend. Then I'm going to tell you what I have on my wish list for London. So I think I'm going to start with the gold palette, and if I like the formula, because I've never tried anything by Natasha Denona before, if I like the formula, then I will consider getting it if it's not sold out. If it's sold out, then that's just too bad for me. But yeah, so it's not going on the wish list, this one. Then I have a new or another release by Natasha Denona, and it's her mini gold palette, and it's launching on the 17th of September, and that's very crappy because I will be in London on the 16th. But still, it's the same thing as with the palette I was talking before, the Metropolis one. I really want to try Natasha Denona before I buy, and I think I have been eyeing the gold palette for so long that I want to start with that palette. And if that is going to be great, then I maybe will buy this one as an addition, because I really like the green shade in this one. And I think there's one double up. I think that the gold shade is a double up for what's already a shade in the gold palette. I've heard, I don't know who's said that. I think Mel Thompson said that. I don't know for sure. But that is going to be the same shade. And the rest of the shades are going to be new. Or at least new if you only have the gold palette. Because it's not in the gold palette. So they're new shades. And I think, I don't know what the price point is really. I have to check. I've checked on the Trendmove page and it's going to be $25 US and it's a mini gold palette with 4 new shades and 1 existing. As I said, the dark sepia is the one that is re-promoted. It's a dark sparkly shade and the rest is new. And she also is going to release new gold glow shimmer duos, and it's going to be 2 gold highlighters, a warm gold super glow and a golden sparking diamond powder, and they are going to be $42 US. So yeah, I'm not going to put it on the wish list per se. I just want to try the gold palette first, and if I like the gold palette, then I probably will get this because I think it's a very nice color scheme and I love greens, and I especially love greens with gold. I don't think I need the highlighter though. That is just something I'm going to skip because, yeah, those colors are not going to look cute on my skin tone. Then, Hourglass Cosmetics has revealed their holiday collection. It's going to be called the Ghost Collection for the holidays, and it's going to be an ambient lighting ghost palette. I think that's the big one, the 6-pan one. Confession refillable lipstick duo. It's going to be a Scattered Lights Glitter Eyeshadow Collection, a Ghost Blush Quad, and an Ambient Lighting Ghost Unlocked, and that's not pictured. So, yeah. I have the holiday palette. I'm going to get it. The holiday palette from last year. This one. This is the one. And this I really love. And I think they are going to re-release this one in the new ghost packaging. So in the transparent and silver packaging. Also for holiday, but it's going to be available only, I don't know, Sephora, Selfridges, I don't remember. But it's going to be a one-time thing. So if you missed out on this one, what's it called? The Ambient Lighting Edit Unlocked. If you've missed out on this one, then you can get it. I'm sorry. I think you should check Charlotte Holdcroft's Instagram. She has it on her Instagram. But yeah, so the holiday palette is, I think, not that interesting for me. Because I think the shades are very pink. And I will have to see it in store. I will be able to do that because it's coming. Hourglass is coming to the Bijenkorf and it's coming on time. It's a store in Holland. And I was so happy when I finally saw that they are coming to a Dutch store. So I will have to see in store if I want to get it. The lipstick, I think, is stunning. And I really want to own a lipstick from them. And I think it's very cool to start with this limited edition packaging because the packaging is really stunning. And I think that the blush quad is quite interesting though, because it has some darker colors, it has some vibrant colors, it has more of a bronzy type of a blush type of color, and it's 4 pan, so maybe it's going to be cheaper than the other one. So that's something I will consider. But as I said, I want to swatch it in store first because this is just, I have the other one, this one, and I love it, but I don't know if I want to spend so much money on a 6-pan palette again. So maybe the quad and the Scattered Lights Glitter Eyeshadow Collection. It's just, you know, you can get the Stila ones, you can get glittery eyeshadow anywhere. And I don't think Hourglass pricing is going to be that good. I have one, and I love it, but I also have other glittery eyeshadows, and I think they're just as good. So yeah. Then Juvia's Place has, in the time I was collecting all the posts, have released 2 eyeshadow palettes in like a week or something like that. And I think one is more interesting than the other. The one I am not that interested in is the Warrior 3 palette. It's going to be $20 US and it's available now on Juvia's Place. And I think it's coming to Beauty Bay as well. When you just hang on tight, it always comes to Beauty Bay. So, and I like to order from Beauty Bay because it's easier for me to get that from Holland. It's just that I am not someone who wears a lot of colorful eyeshadows. I am wearing a very purple look today, and that's very, experimental of me. So I'm not someone who needs a lot of these very vibrant colors. I like very colorful eyeshadow palettes, but I like more the muted colors. So more of the Lethal Cosmetics type of colors. That is what I like. If it's going to be very colorful, then I like them to be muted. Especially the Jawbreaker palette. I'm not interested in that one, but that type of color scheme is more me than this very bright colors. And I think I have one palette already from Juvia's Place. It was there and now I have it. I don't know which one it is. It's with the bright colors. It's a, I think, a 9 pen. I like it. It's just that I am not... Yeah, I have enough colorful eyeshadow. So this is not something I'm that interested in. But the other one is the Nomad palette. And this one I really like because I really like the muted, swampy feel of it. It's like, it's muted, it's warm tone, but also leaning a little bit cool with the gray and the taupe and the only the more orangey color and the two yellow colors are kind of warm. The rest is just cool toned. And I really, really love that. And I think it looks so stunning. The swatches look so stunning. And this is something I am really interested in. So this is going on my wish list. They are going to be 15. It's even $15. It's already available. And I think, does it say that it's coming to 9 pen, 32 Nomad pen size. It's a little bit smaller than the Zulu and bigger than the Nubian. I don't care. I think the, you know, the pen sizes of Juvia's Place is quite big, so I'm happy with any size. I really, really like the color scheme, and yeah, so this is going on the wish list. $15, and I think it will come to Beauty Bay when it comes, and then I'm going to try and get it. Okay, I'm going over to Jouer. Jouer is also a palette and two lippy kind of thing. They have unveiled their limited edition Metamorphosis collection. It's the Metamorphosis Face and Eye palette. It's going to be $34. The Essential Lip Enhancer Shine Balm. That's going to be $18 in two shades. The one is Monarch, that's the soft pink one. And the Mariposa is the black cherry one. And you can also get the bundle for $17. And you know, the thing is, it looks really pretty, and I think that the balm swatches look nice as well. It's just that I'm not going to pay €18 or $18 for a... Is this going to be like €16, I think, for a balm? And it's, for me, it's not very easy to get the Jouer, so this is just not something I'm interested in. And the palette, I think, looks really pretty. I think the swatches look really nice. It has a very... more of a mauve-y, cool-toned look, and I really dig those type of colors, but I think I have them already. So I don't think I will be putting this on the wishlist, but I don't think it's a bad release because I can really, yeah, it's, my eyes is drawing into the pink with the gold and the cool-toned, and it's beautiful, it's beautiful. Then Farsali has, I have to see, is it already here? No, it says coming soon. It's going to be $20, and it's a new addition to the Unicorn family. It's the Unicorn Antioxidant Lip Mask. It's a petal pink lip mask formulated with antioxidant superfruits of goji, acai, blueberry, elderberry to deliver vitamin C and naturally fight signs of aging. Well, that's nice. That's nice. It's like an anti-wrinkle cream for your lips. That's not a bad thing. It's not going on the wish list though, because I already have a little lip mask pot from Laneige in grapefruit, and that is going really slowly, so I'm not going to put this on the wish list, especially because Farsali is just not a very easy brand for me to get to. So yeah, I think it looks interesting. I think that a lip mask and the concept of a lip mask, I love it. Great. But this one is not for me. Then the next thing I want to talk about is the Celestial Storm eyeshadow palette by Dominique Cosmetics. It has already released on the 4th of this month, and it looks really stunning. And I know a lot of people, especially on YouTube, are really intrigued or interested about this brand because they have a very nice quality eyeshadows. I don't own anything by Dominique Cosmetics, but it always looks so very beautiful, and this is no exception. These colors are stunning, and what I love about them is that it's colorful, but it's darker colorful, so you can make a very nice smoky eye with these colors. And the teal, the matte teal and the shiny teal are just screaming my name, and even the purple ones I can, you know, tolerate, because I don't really like the more warmer toned. The matte one, the matte purple, is not really what I'm interested in, but the one above that, the shiny one, that's a very nice one. I think it's more cooler toned, and that suits my eyes a little bit better. Also, the is it a duochrome? I think, I don't know if it's a duochrome. It's like a dark, very dark brownish purple, almost grayish purple. A matte one, it's the matte color. It looks so stunning. Oh no, that's a shiny one. That's a shimmer one. I think it looks so stunning. It's just, I have no idea how to get to Dominique Cosmetics. I think I can get it on Beauty Bay. I'm not sure though, so I would have to check. But yeah, this looks really, really pretty. I'm not going to put it on the wishlist because I want to see if I have similar type of shades. And the thing is, I don't want to be redundant in my collection. I don't want to have a lot of double ups of colors. So I'm going to see if I have them, if I like the formula of those. And then if I don't have them, and this is a unique palette to my collection, then I will put it on the wishlist because I think it looks really, really pretty. Then the next thing is by Give Me Glow. They have released their Vintage Rose collection. It's going to be, or it is, a palette and a few lip items. The lip items I'm not that interested in. I think it's just the liquid lipsticks. And, you know, it's just 5 shades of liquid lipsticks. And an 8 pen eyeshadow palette. And when this was first sneak peeked, I was really intrigued by the colors. And I must say, I still am. Because I really like the combination of the golds and the more really true pinky pink with the more corally pink combined with that. And it's really, like, you know, the packaging really tells you what type of colors of eyeshadows are inside the palette, and I really like that. I don't mind if it doesn't, it's just that I think it's cool that it's Vintage Rose and it really gives you a rose garden feel. I've never tried Give Me Glow, so I have no clue if it's any good. I just really like this palette. It spoke to me because I'm really into these type of colors. Not per se for like my interior now, because I'm living together with my husband. But when I was living alone, I had this very big wall of wallpaper with all these very beautiful pinkish magnolias on the wallpaper, and it looked so, so great. And this really reminds me of it. So maybe I will put it on the wish list, and I'm going to see if I can get to it easily, because I have no clue if I can. I think I just can order from Give Me Glow, and I really want to add some more indie brands to my collection. So I think I'm just going to put this on the wishlist, because this is a color scheme I really dig. So yeah, I'm going to put this on the wishlist. Didn't expect that, but I'm going to do that. Next thing is by Pat McGrath. I have two things by Pat McGrath. She has released two like mini eyeshadow palettes. I think they're called the Eye Ecstasy Minis. And she has a Sublime palette and a Subversive palette, and they're both going to be $28. And they are, I think, shades she has already released in previous palettes. It's just that they bundled it together in two different palettes. And you can try her shimmer formula for less. So the packaging is less luxurious. I don't mind that. I think that's okay. If you're going to pay for packaging, then sure. But if you don't have to pay for packaging, I think that's a good thing too. So yeah, I think this is a very smart way to introduce more people to the brand that don't want to pay, like, what are her palettes? I think there are also $125. So I think that's a lot of money. I don't think I'm going to put this on the wish list. I was really intrigued by both of them. But I don't really like a whole shimmer palette, not even as a complementary palette to other palettes. So this is not going on my wish list. If something would have been on the wish list, I think it would be the right one. And I think that's the Subversive one. But I think there are two shades that even look a lot alike. They're not the same, because one is, it's a golden bronze, so I think that's the Gold Nectar, and the other one is the Blue Blood, but they look a lot alike. So yeah, this is just not something that really piqued my interest, because I just want to start off with a bigger palette. And she also announced a new eyeshadow palette. It's called Midnight Sun. It's the Mothership. I think it's the Mothership range. Yeah, the Motherships. And I think it's the sixth even. Yeah, Mothership 6. I think. I don't know why I can't find it. But it's the Mothership, in the Mothership range, the bigger palette. It's called Midnight Sun. It's going to include 10 shade, Magical Bronzes, Wicked Violets, Mystical Crimsons, and Goddess Gold's Eclipse Eyes with multi-dimensional effects, as per usual. And it's going to be $125, and it's going to be available from September 13th online and in stores. And it says hashtag Sephora, so I hope it's not just in Sephora, because I really want to swatch it when I'm in London. So I hope Selfridges or Harrods also have this palette, so I can see for myself, because it intrigues me a bit. I don't really know if this is the one I want to start off with, because I found another one. I think it's the Sublime one or the Subliminal one. It's going to be on my London wishlist video. I don't know on the top of my head which one I mean, which one I want to get. And there's a purple in here. And as I said in the beginning of the video, purple is not really one of my favorite shades. So I really have to see this in person to see if I think this is special enough to get or just put on my wishlist. I think that the side with all the browns and the mattes and the up until the green is very nice. So if she would make a... if she would make a palette with just those six, then I think I would be very happy to buy that one. I would get it in a heartbeat. It's just that the other four shades are like, okay, I have to see them, swatch them, and see how special they are before I will put them on the wish list. Because, yeah, it's $125, guys. It's a lot of money. But I like the color scheme. I like it. Kathleen Lights and ColourPop are at it again, and they have released a very, very big palette. It's called So Jaded, and they're going to be 30 shades in here. It's the largest palette they have created up onto now. And I think it's very funny. She said, this is my 2,305,834th collab with ColourPop. So I wanted to do something they hadn't done before. And I think that is really fun. I think it's really funny that she is like joking around about the many collabs Kathleen Lights did with ColourPop. It's just, I think she's a very funny girl. I don't really follow her on Instagram, on YouTube, because I follow a lot of people and some more smaller influencers. I like that more than just a big one. But I think Kathleen Lights is a very fun girl. It's just I don't have time to also follow her and watch her stuff. So yeah, it's going to be... it's already released, because it has launched on the 6th of September. And it's $39. Sorry guys, my camera stopped. So I'm just going to... do this again, or sort of again. What I was saying was that I think it looks a lot like a Morphe palette, but I think that's not very surprising, as it's just a big palette with round pans in there. And I have to say, I really like the colors. It's just that I don't think I need them, because I have a lot of these colors already, because I own a lot of ColourPop and I own a lot of Morphe, so I already have these colors. But I think it's nice. It's colorful, but it's wearable. And the colors are not like screaming into your face. So it's not like a rainbow palette, but it has a lot of nice colors. So you can make some fun little looks out of this. And I think it's a very inspiring palette. Such a big palette, because if I look at it, I can see a few looks I would want to create with it. So yeah, I think it's a nice release, and I think it's fun that Kathleen has some humor about the amount of collab she did with ColourPop. So yeah, not going on the wish list, but I don't mind it. Then the next thing is also eyeshadow. It's just not a palette. It's by Chantecaille. Chantecaille have released, I think they have released them weeks and weeks ago already. They have released 2, 4, 6 single eyeshadows. So all the shades have these animals on them. I think they are inspired by the animal that they represent. And all proceeds go to, or at least part of the proceeds are going to a charity that is supporting or helping these endangered, I would say, a species. So I think that's really great. They're going to be, or they are, $52 a pop. That's quite up there. But a Chantecaille, it's a luxury brand, and I think that the colors are really stunning. It's like this very nice shimmery type of colors. Michelle Wong. Michelle Wong has received these colors received the shadows by Chantecaille, and she bought them. So that was like really cute that she also got them in PR. But yeah, she has swatched them, and she made a whole video about it. So if you want to see that, then go over to her channel. And I think, I don't know if I can get to Chantecaille in London. I'm going to really look for them, because I would love to get the rhinoceros color. I think it is stunning, and also the elephant one is begging to be picked up by me, but I really want to make a choice, because they are $52, so they're going to be like £45, €45, something like that. And I think that's a lot of money for just one shade. So, but I really like them, and I really want to support the charities they have worked with. So I think if I can find them, I will pick up the rhinoceros one, but I'm not going to reserve a space on my regular wish list. I'm going to reserve a spot on my London wish list. So yeah, sort of going on the wish list, but not the same one. Then I want to give some attention to the collab with Davina Cosmetics and Angelica Nykvist. I love Angelica. She is so much fun. She's such a nice lady, and she uploads like 5 times a week or something like that. There's always something to watch from her, and I just really love her. And she does a lot of colorful eyeshadow looks, and she has collabed with Davina to make a custom palette with shades she really loves by the brand. And I think that is really fun, because she has been a big fan of Davina for a very long time. And yeah, she knows the shade, she knows what she likes, and she made a perfect palette for her. And I think it's a really cool palette. I own a few of these shades already, because I really like Davina Cosmetics as well. And these colors are really stunning. I really love their formula. So I think it's great that she collabed with them. And I think the palette that it comes in, the little, What's it called? Holographic. Dang it. The holographic palette is really fun and really Angelica. So I think it is so nice. And what she did, she created 2. I don't know if I will be able to see it. No, I don't know. She created 2 eyeshadows out of 2 existing highlighters. And I think that is really fun, because you can just, you know, it's a powder product. You can multi-use it for anything you want. So you can use your highlighters on your eyes. And I think it's really fun that you made the highlighter shades into eyeshadow pens and put this in this palette. The palette is called the Moonwell palette, and it's going to be $48, and you can use her code AngeSka20 to get, I think, 20% off, I would say. It's already launched, it's already sold out, but they're trying to restock. So yeah, if you want it, you just have to check out the Davina Cosmetics website. I am not going to put it on the wish list, but that's because I already have a few of these shades, and I think that would be a bit redundant. But I think it's great that Davina and Angelica did this collab. So yeah, that's fun. The next one is by Melt Cosmetics, and Melt Cosmetics have released their... Oh no, it's launching in September. It's in September. I don't know if it has already launched. It is going to launch in September. It's the 11th right now, so it could be already out. And it's called the Radioactive Palette. And I think it's so fun and so stunning. I love that it's so colorful and I'm not going to put it on the wish list. It's like, oh, I love this and it looks so fun. I think it looks really great and I think it looks really fun. And especially the teal color and the very dark teal next to it look stunning. But there's also two purple shades in there and I'm not going to get a lot of purple shades. I don't really like purple. I've already said this over and over and over again. And the four very colorful colors, it's like I have ordered some eyeshadow palettes that have these type of colors in them. I have got the BH Cosmetics colorful palette. I have, for someone who doesn't really wear that much, those type, that's what I wanted to say. I got the Kaleidos palettes and there are some neon colors in there and that is just already a lot of colors. I'm like, okay, I'm not even going to use them really a lot. So I'm not going to get this palette because I won't be reaching for it that much. And I think I should not just buy colorful palettes if I don't use them. But I think when I first saw, I was like, oh, I want to have this, I want to have this. And then I was like, okay, why? Because there's a lot of purple in there. You don't wear purple. You don't wear that colorful eyeshadows. And you already have a few of these shades. So just, you know, curb yourself a little bit. So yeah, I really love this, but it's not going on the wish list. This last thing is going on the wish list. Oh yes, ma'am, definitely. It's the new Dark Edit palette by Viseart. They have released a new, or are going to release, I think it's already here. Yes, it has launched on the 1st of September. You can get it on Beautylish for $39. But the thing is, Viseart is also for sale for on Boozy Shop. It's a Dutch, like, it's a Dutch beauty bay type of thing. It's a website with a lot of beauty products. And Viseart is also sold on their website. And if I order it from Beautylish, I have to pay taxes, and if I just wait till it gets to Boozy Shop, then I will be able to get it there without taxes, and it's going to be the same price. And this is a palette that is really screaming my name. I love these dark brown colors, and yes, there's a purple in here, but it's a purple I can skip, or I can forgive, or I can, I don't know, top off with the pinky color or combine it with the green. I don't know. There's purple in everything. There's purple in every palette. Why? But okay, that's just my problem. So I can forgive the purple, but I really love this color scheme because it's like almost, it's warm, but it's really deep warm. And there's this mossy green in there that I really, really dig. And I like the four shimmery shades. They look very bright in here, but I've seen it on a few influencers. I don't know who did the video on it. I think Mel Thompson, of course, Mel, did a video on this palette already. And I think that the colors look a lot more darker and more murky in real life and not this bright. Because if they would be this bright, then I don't know if I would be that interested in the shimmers. But yeah, they look... in the swatches, they look really nice. So yeah, this is something that is going on the wishlist because I really, really want to get this palette. Okay guys, that was all I wanted to talk about this week. It was a lot of palettes. I have been trying to time myself and not to ramble on about everything too much. I think I kept it like a decent time frame. So I hope this video won't be too long. I hope. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked this video. If you did, then please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. I promise I will be more regular with my uploads in the coming weeks. It's just, I have to, yeah, there's some stuff going on. And as I said, I'm not going to elaborate on that, but it's just, it keeps me from filming. It's okay. It will be okay. So please forgive me. I hope you will stick around and I hope I will see you in my next one. Bye!